Hello students,
here is your teacher Neha, and in today's video I am going to explain the shapes of atomic orbitals. So before starting, just subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you get the necessary notification about the upcoming videos, and do share with your friends also. So let us start the shape of atomic orbitals. Now starting with the term orbital. Orbital is what? Is the region of the space around the nucleus within which the probability of finding the electron is maximum. That means about 90% chances are there the electron is present, can be found there in that region. This region is known as orbital. The probability of any point around the nucleus is calculated by using Schrödinger wave equation, and it is represented by the density of points. The shape of the electron cloud thus obtained gives the shape of the orbital. Let us see the shapes of different orbitals. So the Schrödinger wave equation is solved to get the value of psi. And this gives the coordinate of the electron. Suppose it is the x, y and z. They are the coordinates of an electron, and it is obtained by solving the equation, Schrödinger wave equation, for the function psi. Psi itself has no physical significance, but the psi square has significance as it gives the electron probability density of the electron at that point. Now the variation of psi and psi square at different distances from the nucleus can be plotted as, and it can be represented as such. This, the first diagram is the variation of psi with nuclear distance r for 1s orbital. The second one is the variation of psi with nuclear distance r for 2s orbital. This graph shows the variation of psi square with respect to r for 1s, and this is variation of psi square with respect to r for 2s orbital. You can observe here the probability of 1s electron is found to be maximum near the nucleus. This is maximum near the nucleus. You can say it is having the highest value, and it decreases gradually from the as the distance from the nucleus increases. In case of 2s, the electron, 2s electrons also, the probability is again maximum near the nucleus. It decreases to zero and again increases, and then again decreases. Okay, it is for the 2s. The intermediate region, that means where it touches the this axis, where it touches here, there is the probability of finding electron is zero. Hai na? Psi square is zero here. So the probability becomes zero here when it touches this line. This is called node. What it is called? It is called node. Node are the regions where the probability of finding the electron is zero within the atom. Okay. Now alternatively, the point where the wave function, where the wave function changes from positive sign to negative sign, is called node. Here you can see that the sign of wave function is changing in case of 2x orbital. It is positive here, it decreases to zero, then becomes negative. So at the junction, at the point where the graph intersects the axis, it is called node. Okay, these are the probability variation of the psi and psi square with the nuclear distance. The probability density variation can be visualized in terms of electron cloud diagrams also. See here, 1s orbital, 2s orbital and 3s orbital. You can clearly see here 1s orbital has no node. There is a gap here between two electron charge cloud. This gap is the node in 2s orbital. So 2s orbital contain one node. Similarly, in 3s orbital, there are two gaps between the three cloud. 1s orbital, 2s orbital and then 3s orbital. So it has the three nodes. Sorry, it has the two nodes. 3s orbital, it is 3s orbital and it has the two nodes only. Okay, now we can explain the shape of s orbital in the following ways. The probability of the finding electron belonging to s orbital of any mention is found to be identical in all direction. See, it is identical in all direction from the nucleus. Okay, that means the electron charge cloud is distributed evenly, uniformly around the nucleus. Thus, we can say that s orbital is spherical in shape and it is symmetrical around the nucleus. For s orbital, we have L equal to 0. We have L equal to 0 and corresponding magnetic quantum number M is also equal to 0. Right? That means it only has one value. S orbital has only one value. That means only one orientation. Thus, the only shape possible for the S orbital is the spherical shape. Now, the S orbitals are spherical in shape. Now, 1s, 2s, 3s, all orbitals have spherical shape. All the S orbitals are having the spherical shape. Then, how they differ from each other? They differ from each other in number of nodes. See here, 0 node, 1 node and 2 nodes. And they also differ in their size. It is smaller, it is bigger than 1s, 3s is bigger than 2s. So, as the number of principal quantum number increases, the value, that is the size and the energy of the s orbital also increase. Now, let us see the shapes of p orbital. Now, on the basis of probability calculations, it is found that the probability of finding the p electrons, probability of finding the p electron is maximum in the two lobes on the opposite side of the nucleus. And this gives rise to dumbbell shape for the p orbital. Thus, the shape of the p orbital electron charge cloud can be represented as this. Here you can see there are two lobes which constitute the p orbital, and due to its shape, it is called dumbbell shape. And here the probability of finding a particular p electron is equal in both lobes. Okay, this is the electron charge cloud, and probability of finding the electron, p electron, is equal in both lobes. And as you can see, there is a plane. There is a plane which passes through the nucleus on which the probability of finding the electron is zero. Right? And this plane is called nodal plane. This is called nodal plane. Now for p orbital, value of L is equal to 1. Right? And M, it is having minus 1, 0 and plus 1. Okay, so since three values of m are possible, the p orbitals have three different orientations in space. Okay, you can say that one p orbital is oriented towards x axis, one towards y and one towards z. On the basis, this notations are given according to the according to whether the electron density is maximum along x axis or y axis or z axis respectively. Now, unlike s orbitals, which were spherical in shape and were symmetrical around the nucleus, p orbitals have directional characteristics. है ना, दे हैव स्पेशली ओरिएंटेशन अलॉन्ग द एक्सिस, वेदर इट मे बी एक्स एक्सिस, इट मे बी वाई एक्सिस और इट मे बी जेड एक्सिस. सो दे हैव डायरेक्शनल प्रॉपर्टीज एंड हेंस आर वेरी यूजफुल इन प्रेडिक्टिंग द शेप्स ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल. ओके, नाउ एवरी एनर्जी लेवल विद एन ग्रेटर दैन वन, दैट मीन्स एन ग्रेटर दैन वन has three p orbitals. Okay, every energy level which has the value n greater than 1, that means the principal shell will first principal shell hai na, first will not have any p orbital, but greater than 1 like 2 3 4 5 will have the p orbitals and have it becomes as the n increases the p orbitals becomes larger and larger in size and have higher energies also. Hence, but the p orbital for a particular energy level, there are three orbitals possible na for one value of l. So for a particular energy level, suppose it is for n equal to 2 and 2 and a second principal shell will have three orbitals. Okay, and for the particular energy shell, the p orbital will have equal energy. Okay, further 2p has no node. Here you can conclude that 2p will have no node and 3p has one and 4p has two and so on. Okay, this is the way you can we can represent the px py pz as follows. See here, different orientations of the p orbitals can be given like this. Now let us see different shapes of d orbital. For d orbital, l will have value 2, hence the corresponding value of m will be -2, -1, 0, +1, and +2. On the basis of probability calculation, their shapes can be drawn like this. So you can see here that the 5 d orbitals can be represented like this. Dxy is the orbital whose lobes are in the plane of xy. Xy on xy plane the lobes are lying, whereas in dyz orbital the lobes are lying in the plane of yz, that's why they are named like this. In xz the lobes of the d orbital are on the plane of yz, whereas in the dx square minus y square in this orbital the lobes are lying on the axis of x and y, whereas in the dz square the lobes are lying on the z axis. Okay, and you can see here a cloud, a donut like shape of this orbital. Okay, it has a donut like shape. This is xy axis. So it may be concluded that the dz square has a donut shaped electron cloud in the center, whereas other d orbitals have clover leaf like shape. Okay, and if we see that node, about the node, then 3d has no node, 4d has one node and 5d has two and so on. The first principal shell that is having the d orbital is the third shell, 3d. So 3d will have no node, and then there will be one node will increase as the principal shell will increase. Okay, this is all about the structure of atomic orbitals. Thank you.